let's do some analysis on the back of this. Adeep Sani is a security analyst who's been following the development and joins me live in the studio. Adeep, thank you very much for your time. I know you've been following investigations in relation to this matter. What's your own perspective on this?
Well, the issues coming up lately is something I find disturbing. A number of high-ranked police officers have been invited already, but what we need to be very circumspect about is whether they have been arrested or perhaps they've been invited to assist in the investigation.
Well, we're told in the case of ACP Kofi Buachi, he stated that he was invited, but in the case of the other one who Lawyer Kpebu is represented, he has actually been arrested and charged.
Well, that is the information coming up. But, Pakwesi, you see, the problem is when you're dealing with issues of national security, like it is with this matter, it is important we exercise a great deal of tact in the information flow. This is not a soccer game. You don't expect that a live commentary is given, whatever is done. Some of the issues that has come up point to the fact that the information hasn't been well managed, okay? And we're dealing with something that borders on national security. So sometimes it is not always necessary that we're giving live updates about whatever is going on.
You this think is it's a serious a matter. Tendency to destabilize the police service?
Well, not destabilize the police service per se, but it would definitely ruffle some feathers. And I must also indicate, we are in the streets. We engage the people on a daily basis. We sit in the trotters, in the taxis. This is creating something more like fear and panic. And it's dividing the population.
Because why should already be creating fear and panic? If people are planning to destabilize a constitutionally elected government and that is treasonable. I mean, that's a matter that should be definitely be taken up and dealt with.
Of course, this is something that had to do with subverting the security of the state. And the information coming out points to the fact that we're almost at the brink. And perhaps more persons would be invited. So you wouldn't know. Perhaps the same person you're sleeping in the bedroom with might be invited the next minute. But what is particularly disturbing is the political connotation that is already going into this, okay? And it's dividing the population.
And perhaps I don't think the stature of the police officers that are involved in this matter, is that what you're talking about?
Absolutely, no doubt about that, okay? I have received some information. Of course, I cannot say on TV, but it is disturbing. And like I always indicate, we are a country that is governed by the rule of law. We have procedures to follow when you feel your rights are violated. I expect that the state would accord them their rights and let them go through that legal process. And I must also indicate that the fact that you have been arrested by the BNI or the police doesn't point to the fact that you're guilty until a competent court of jurisdiction finds you guilty before you be described as such. So we really need to be very careful about the way we go with these things. From day one, I've been on this network, I've said it over and over again, the information management has been poorly done, especially from the information ministry, because what is being peddled around is not consistent. There's a discorrelation of some sort between the information out there and the evidence we have on the ground.
Right.
For crying out loud, Pakwesi, the persons of Dr. Agordzo's stature would definitely not orchestrate a coup on WhatsApp. When you and I, when we all know for a fact that there is nothing secretive about the phones we use. Look, the calls you make, the pictures you take, the SMSs you send, the WhatsApp messages you send, even if it is deleted, after a number of years, it can be recalled. So obviously you don't expect that persons of their caliber would orchestrate a coup on a WhatsApp platform. And I'm saying this without mincing words, okay? And taking into consideration that my credibility is the most important thing to me right now. All this is something I find more like a shroud. It's a joke. I
must. Adeep Sani, I've got to say a big thank you to you. Adeep Sani is a security analyst helping us to do some analysis on the back of this developing story. We're obviously on the beat and we'll bring you the very latest with regards to this.